Hi there, I'm Black Bright, and I'm talking to you as Myrna Loy, the owner of the Inspirational Herbal Tea Kitchen, which is TIHTK. And the reason why I decided to talk about it today is because I had an exhibition last night at the Wardown Art Museum and Gallery. So on the back, I had some of my teas. I had Sorrel, I had Irish Moss, and I had a Luton tea. Well, it's a Luton tea tonic. It's actually, it cures, you know, it's for the immune system, it's for diabetes, it's all that kind of stuff. Anyway, when I'd done my speech and I'd done my little talk and everything I needed to do, I went to the back for a tea break. And somebody, I asked somebody if they wanted the sorrel, and they said to me, oh, I make sorrel, I don't want to try the sorrel. And it made me think, you know, people think there's only one type of sorrel or one type of thing. And it reminded me of people. People will say, they can say, I'm white, so therefore these are my characteristics. I could say, I'm black, these are my characteristics. And the same with that bottle of sorrel. Now, that bottle of sorrel, anyone can make it, but we all make it differently. I mean, you have African sorrel, you have Jamaican sorrel. You probably have other sorrels around the world, but those are the main ones. You have African ginger and you have Chinese ginger. Depending on what kind of spices you use, whether it's nutmeg, cinnamon, allspice, cloves, whatever spices, you also have that addition. You also have whether it's alcoholic or non-alcoholic. The alcohol one will have red label wine and it will have Ray and Nephew overproof rum. Or you have the non-alcoholic. And what else was there? Oh, you can have the granulated sugar. Some might use granulated sugar, while I tend to use organic cane sugar. So depending on what type of sorrel you make will determine how it tastes. And it's just like the makeup of individuals. Depending on what kind of experiences you have, you will come out different from the next person. Not all black people are alike, not all white people are alike. The same way, not all of TIHTK's sorrel is alike. So what I decided to do today is I'm going to have a tasting session. So all those people who come in and say, oh, I can make sorrel, you haven't tried my sorrel. And what was interesting is that those who drank the sorrel actually bought a couple of bottles. So it does mean that, and also, you know what some people do? They use the sorrel mixture, you know, once they've boiled it all together, they use it over and again. So it loses its potency. All I'm saying is that different strokes for different folks. The Herbal Tea Kitchen is located at Unit 79, Luton Indoor Market, which is on Market Street in Luton. It's actually in the Arndale Centre, the back of the Arndale Centre. I am not doing this on a big scale. I am doing this on a specialised scale for Lutonians. I'm keeping Luton healthy. I don't intend to branch out. People say, oh, you know, you never know where it's going to lead. I don't intend to branch out and make all these bottles and have a headache. I'm just doing a simple service to see how people feel. It's my birthday today and I'm 69 and I feel as though I am qualified to show people what works from what doesn't work. And especially with regards to being healthy, putting yourself out there. Now, it takes courage to do what I do. I mean, I'm always changing myself. I'm always changing my hair. I'm always changing the way I dress. They used to call me a chameleon. So I stand up like a sore thumb. People take a second take. They're not quite sure who they're going to see this week, who they're going to see next week. But it keeps them interested. It keeps them curious. And for me, it takes a bit of courage to be different. Our lives is about conformity. We all do the same thing, don't we? We don't want to stand out. And my mum always used to say, Myrna, don't draw attention to yourself. What did she mean? Don't be an individual. Don't be unique. And I am, because I was rebellious back then. I'm not rebellious now. I've just got into a habit of presenting myself the way I feel at a particular moment. So it will be different because I feel different at different moments. That doesn't mean my core self isn't stable. It just means my superficial outside self is changeable, and it changes with the mood. And I was in the talk I was doing yesterday, I was saying, how do we identify ourselves? Are we numbers? Are we account numbers? Are we NHS numbers? You know, and people could identify with that. So we're not just who we say on our passport. We're not who we say on our driving license. When people phone up and say, oh, what's your postcode? What number? And your name comes up. That's not who we are. We're all individuals, just as individual as my bottle of Sorrel. So I've made some more Sorrel today. So like I said, I'm going to do a little taster. I've also made some bay leaf, clove, and ginger tea. Just look up the benefits for that because I can't do it off of my head and I've got to go to the shop. And I've also made some sarsaparilla. That's good for arthritis. I've also made morbi. That's a good toxifying drink, tonic. And yeah, so I'm doing what I found was this. I'm going to go off the track now. But you know what's the beauty of starting, taking that first step? You never know where it's going to lead. You like with the shop, started off selling herbal teas, boxes of herbal teas. Next thing I know, people around are selling herbal teas and putting them to the traders are putting their teas to the front of their shops. In other words, they're trying to outdo me. And I'm thinking to myself, look, you're selling capsules, you're selling all kinds of stuff. Why now, just because I'm selling herbal teas, you decide to promote your herbal teas? Because they want to monopolise the market. So I thought, okay, no skin off my nose. What can we do differently? You don't be afraid of the competition. What can I do differently that they can't do, that they can't replicate? So I started making own herbal teas. At that time, I had somebody working with me in the shop and he had a garden and we used all of the, what he was growing, like fennel, lemon balm, mint, and what else? Rhubarb. Yeah, he had a lot of products in his garden. And so when we were working together, that was such a brilliant idea. That is what gave me the idea of creating a customized or signature blend of herbal tea, something that the other traders could not emulate. So now what I've extended that, because that person is no longer around, so I've extended that idea into getting it my own way. And it started off with meeting a young lady. She had an ailment. She's been allowed to grow angelica root. Now, angelica doesn't normally grow in this country. It's from Southern America. But she's been allowed to grow it. And she gave me this angelica root and the leaves. And she said I could plant it. I didn't know how to preserve it, so it died. But I did manage to make some angelica teas. Angelica, look it up. I haven't got my notes here, and I'd have piles and piles of notes if I was going to go through each tea and tell the properties. So I'm not going to do that here. That's not the purpose of this video. So I started making angelica, and because it's so bitter, I added some ginger and I added some mint and, you know, a little bit of manuka honey. So that was one tonic. And it's just excelled from there. Now, because I'm studying the herbal teas, even though I can't roll them off my tongue at the moment, it's still a new enterprise, only 3 months old. I can now, I feel I could. Somebody said to me, oh, I've got joint pain. I feel I could say to them, okay, I'm not going to say it cures anything because you can't guarantee anything. And I'm not taking over from the doctors or the GP and everybody has to get professional medical advice. I'm not saying that. I'm saying that some of the herbal teas can help. They can help ease. So I would look up I'd research the ailment and then see if I can make a tonic to curb that ailment. Still trying to work on my hair. See if it works. You'll soon know if I start going natural whether the tonic I'm using for my hair is going to work. But that's going to take a few months, I would imagine, if it is going to work. I haven't seen much change yet. And that's what I'm saying. It's trial and error. But I know the mulberry bark. I know that definitely works because I've tried it myself. And I try most of the drinks. But because I don't, touch wood, have many ailments, and when I do, I concentrate on a particular remedy, I just go with what I'm doing. I just want to make it simple, and that's why I said I'm not aiming to do online. People say, have you got a website? No, I haven't got a website. I offer a personal service. You come into the TIHTK in Luton Indoor Market and I will serve you, and you can sit down, have a cup of tea, or you can take it away. My teas are, you can have them hot or cold. I'm not posting out anything. If you can't get to me, it doesn't matter. But I am focusing on Lutonians, only because Luton is not too far from where I live. It's one city over, and that's where my premises are. And I'm not about to expand, so I have to have staff and all that. That I haven't got time for. Mind you, if somebody came to me and said, look, I'm willing to do this for you and show you how to do that, maybe, just maybe, if all of that stress was taken off of my head. But I'm not at the moment planning to expand. I just want to focus on Luton and keep Luton healthier than what it is, or at least try to, or at least be a facilitator in that. And that's all for now. Bye-bye.